Good morning everyone, this is Kanupriya and you are watching KP's Motivational Chatbox. A very warm welcome to my YouTube channel, that is KP's Motivational Chatbox. There is a well-known saying that etiquette is a term that is invented by wise men to keep the foolish people away, or there are certain things in this universe that can't buy manners, that can't buy ethics, that can't buy discipline. These are certain things that we can't buy with the help of money. So etiquettes are the way to show others that you respect them. So be a kind and professionally digital citizen so that you can behave in a proper way in front of others while you are socializing with others on internet. So why I am saying you, or why I am talking about etiquettes today? Let me take you to the classes while we are sitting in a school. Teacher is teaching in a class and students are showing respect to their teachers by listening the lectures carefully. Or also when any student want to ask any question from the teacher, they must be raising their hands. This is something etiquettes are, right? So these all are the classroom etiquettes. But now on the other hand, or on the contrary, what about the internet etiquettes? Because nowadays in this pandemic we all are on the internet all the time, right? So we are attending the online courses, we all are giving the online webinars, we all are giving the seminars or certain online classes with the help of internet only. So what all is this? This is all socializing with others. It may be any education purpose or it may be any other purpose, right? So for being socializing or to be on the internet or to deliver any class on the internet, you must know certain etiquettes for the internet also, right? So there is a term netiquette. There is a term netiquette which is related to internet, and it consists of two words, internet plus etiquettes, right? So that means there are certain rules and certain guidelines that you have to follow while you are socializing on the internet, or while you are sending email to others, while you are sending any message to others, while you are doing any post on Facebook, while you are sending any message to any of your friend, any of your teacher or any other person, right? So there are certain rules and certain guidelines that you must need to follow while you are on the internet, while you are using the internet or doing online activity, right? So today I will be explaining certain guidelines that will help you to be a smart and professionally person, so that you can converse or you can do online communication with others in a confident and very good manner, right? So let me start with my guidelines. The very first guideline is be on time. What do you mean by be on time? For example, your teacher has given you a class time for 8:45 and teacher is coming online at 9 o'clock. So is this good thing? I don't think so. It is a good thing, because these all are the netiquettes the teacher or even student has to follow. That means student and teachers must have to be on time while any online class is being conducted. So be on time so that you can't miss any of the important points, and even before starting the class, be 5 minutes before prior to the class, right? So that you can't miss any point or any other important thing the teacher is going to discuss further. So the next point is read properly before posting. For example, you are doing any post on Facebook or you are sending any post to certain group of people. So you have to do that posting in such a way that it can't show any bad message to others. So avoid sarcastic language and be polite and humble while you are posting a message on the Facebook, and try to give a valuable and helpful message to others so that people get convinced by your message, or it may persuade them to read your message. So this is something that you have to include in read properly before posting. Also, read your message, draft your message, and then read it properly so that you can avoid any grammar mistake or any spelling mistake or any other sarcastic language. Now the third point is be on the top. For example, you are having a webinar on netiquette, right? And teacher is discussing something else. So what's the use of giving the topic? Is there any use of giving the topic? No. So be on the topic and try to give number of examples, real life examples or practical implementations if possible with you people, and be on the particular topic that you have given to the students and make your conversation clear in a very easy manner. The next point is use proper salutations. What do you mean by use proper salutations? Use proper salutations means always greet the audience with dear or respected, and at the end also always greet the audience with your signature or by your sincerely or by thanking the people so that they can feel great, right? Now the next point is be polite and confident. While you are giving any online class or while you are conducting any online session, you have to be very much polite in this way, as I am getting polite now, right? So you have to be very much polite and confident so that the person who is listening to you makes the other person to see you, right? So present yourself in this way that they love to see you, right? So be confident and smart enough to present yourself in front of others. So the next point is respect other opinions. You are giving a seminar, you are giving a webinar on the internet, and you are not respecting the opinions. So this is a very bad thing, because the leader is the one who accept the opinions, who accept the feedbacks and suggestions always. Once you finish your conversation, try to accept the opinions from the others, because sometimes it's not necessary that you are always right, or it may happen that sometimes it is not necessary that your thoughts are always welcomed by others. So try to accept the opinions of others and take it in a positive way and try to improve yourself if you can, right? Next point is remember please and thank you. Before starting any session, you have to greet the audience in a very cheerful manner and use please and thank you word at the starting and at the end, right? Or in between if needed. So it will help the audience to know about you, your etiquette or your netiquette. So that means you are a good person and you are very polite and courteous person, right? Next one is respect others' privacy. So what about privacy? Because internet is a very vast thing, right? So privacy is the most important thing on internet, right? So always try to maintain the privacy of the others by not opening the documents related to others without their permission, without their consent, right? So always try to maintain the privacy and do not share any information of other people with any other person. So because it will create a trouble for you in future and also keeps your performance down, right? And it doesn't look nice when you are sharing other information with anyone else. So try to be confident and be general. The next and the last point is obey copyright laws. As we all know that on internet you have certain things there are having copyright laws. That means there are certain information available on the internet. That means they are having a copyright law on the information, and you can't copy that content from that site to your site, right? So even if you are copying any text or anything from any particular site or any other blog, you have to mention the name of that particular site or thing so that it will be act as a reference to the site and it will not obey the copyright rules and regulations of the site, right? So this is something very important while you are conducting online session, while you are communicating with others, because these all are the things that makes you a perfect online communicator or the person who are used to be on the internet all the time. So if you are a very used to be person for the internet, you have to follow these guidelines and rules to be a perfect and smart communicator or the teacher, right? So this is something about today's topic, right? So now at the end, I would like to say to all of you, please share my YouTube channel's link with other persons and do subscribe it, and also press the bell icon button to get more notifications, and stay tuned for more videos, and thank you very much.